Good morning, students. Welcome to All for C Learning. Yesterday we discussed about distance and displacement in kinematics one dimensional motion. Today I will discuss some more problems related to distance and displacement concept. Note down, students, sit with book and pen. A monkey walks 30 meters east and then turns northwards for another and walks for another 40 meters and finally climbs a pole of height 50 meters. Find the distance and displacement of the monkey. Students, this is the question. This question can be solved in two ways. I will explain the problem in two ways. First, method one. Monkey walks 30 meters east. So, first consider the directions. This is east, this is north. So, monkey walks 30 meters towards east. And then turns towards north for another 40 meters. Walks for another 40 meters. Finally, it climbs the pole of height 50 meters. Here the pole is in this direction. So, to understand the situation, let us draw a cuboid whose sides are 30 meters and 40 meters. Suppose this is our origin, this is vertical direction, this is horizontal direction, and this is also horizontal direction. I am considering this as x axis and this as y axis and this as z axis. If you consider this monkey walks 30 meters towards east. So, here this x axis also represents east and this y axis also represents north. This vertically upward direction is indicated by z axis. So, this is upwards. So, monkey first walks 30 meters towards east. This is 30 meters and then turn towards north. Here monkey takes a turn towards north and then continued for 40 meters. So, this length is 40 meters and then climbs a pole of height 50 meters. This is a pole, suppose this pole height is 50 meters. So, they are asking what is the distance and displacement travelled by the monkey. So, clearly distance travelled by the monkey is 30 meters plus 40 meters plus 50 meters. What is distance? Distance is actual length of the path. Monkey walks like this and then takes a turn and rides and then climbs the pole. So, this is 30 meters plus 40 meters plus 50 meters. So, distance travelled by the monkey is 30 plus 40, 70, 70 plus 50, 120 meters. Next, what is the displacement? Clearly, it is the length of the body diagonal of the cuboid. Here monkey starts from origin O and reaches some point P. So the shortest length between the two will be the body diagonal of the cuboid. It is not the face diagonal, it is the body diagonal of the cuboid. To find this length, we know cuboid's body diagonal length is, body diagonal, suppose this is cuboid of a side lengths L, B and H, suppose this is L and this is B, this is H, what is the body diagonal length? Body diagonal is under root L square plus B square plus H square. So clearly displacement of monkey, displacement of monkey is under root of body diagonal length. Length is some 30, some breadth is some 40, height is some 50. So this is 30 square plus 40 square plus 50 square, right? This is 900 plus 600 under root 900 plus 1600 plus 2500. So this is root of, this is 2500 plus 2500, that is 1500. Its value is 50 root 2 meters. Here the displacement is a vector quantity, its direction is represented with OP cap. This is the displacement direction. So here we have to mention OP cap. So displacement of monkey is 50 root 2 meters OP cap, whereas distance is 30 plus 40 plus 50, that is 120 meters. For a displacement, no need to mention direction. We know that a distance is a vector quantity, whereas displacement is a scalar quantity. Students, I am explaining second method. To solve the problem in second method, first we consider the coordinate system. This is x-axis and this is y-axis, and this vertically upward direction is z-axis. I am considering this x-axis as east and this y-axis as north, and vertically upward direction as z-axis. We clearly know that. So now represent each moment of the monkey as a vector. Each moment of the monkey as a vector. So now this monkey walks 30 meters east and 40 meters towards north and finally 50 meters towards upwards, 50 meters upwards. So I am writing this displacement as first displacement, some S1, and this displacement as second displacement S2, and third displacement vertically upward direction, that is S3. I can't show here, this is S3, so it is vertically upwards. I am writing each displacement as a vector quantity. Yesterday we discussed some of the, all these displacements gives the resultant displacement. So this S1 bar, this S1 bar is 30 I cap. First displacement is, this monkey walks towards east. East direction I am considering as x-axis. So this S1 bar is nothing but 30 I cap. Students, first learn how to write this direction, east direction, as x-axis. First learn that one. Then S1 bar is 30 I cap. Similarly, S2 bar is this is 40, this is y direction displacement. Second case, monkey turns left and takes walks for 40 meters. This displacement towards north, so it is taken as y direction. So this is 40 j cap. Next, the third displacement, monkey climbs the pole. Monkey climbs the pole. So that displacement S3 can be written as this is upward direction is z axis. We know that. So it is z axis. Here is the S3. It is outward. So this is 50 k cap. We know that total displacement is given by sum of individual displacements. So this S bar is given by S1 bar plus S2 bar plus S3 bar. So this S bar is 30 I cap plus 40 j cap plus 50 k cap. Okay, students, the magnitude of displacement. What is the magnitude of displacement? This is under root 30 square plus 40 square plus 50 square. On solving this, we again get 50 root 2 meters, same as in method 1. Now, what is the direction of this displacement? The direction is given by unit vector of this displacement vector. So the displacement vector here is S bar is 30 I cap plus 40 j cap plus 50 k cap. So S cap, what is S cap? S cap is a unit vector in the direction of S bar. So this S cap gives the direction of this displacement in vector form. So this is 30 s cap is s bar by mod s. We already calculated mod s, simply s. So this can be written as 30 I cap plus 40 j cap plus 50 k cap by under root 50 under root. This is direction of the displacement vector. Like this, you can solve the problem in two ways. One method is by simply drawing a cuboid and finding its body diagonal length that gives the displacement of monkey. And in second case, take the coordinate system and represents the vectors at their positions and find their resultant. Students, this is our second problem. Problem is, a person walks 30 meters north, takes a turn towards east and walks for 20 meters, and finally turns southwest, turned southwest, southward direction and covers 30 root 2 meters, find the distance and displacement of that person. So every time to solve two methods, it takes a lot of time. So I am solving this problem in vector method. So to solve this problem in vector method, take the coordinate system. This is coordinate system, x-axis as east, y-axis as north, vertically upward direction as z-axis. So present, person walks 30 meters towards north. So this person walks 30 meters towards north. So this is first displacement of that person, S1 bar. After that, he takes a turn towards east and continued for 20 meters. So from here onwards he started walking for 20 meters. This is second displacement of that person. And finally southwest and covered a distance of 30 root 2 meters. Southwest means it is at an angle 45 degrees. This is southwest, this is west, this is west, and this is south. So center line, this is southwest. So if you extend like this, here is the displacement some S3. I don't know where it comes. This is our S3. This is S3. How to write these vectors in vector form? It is easy to write S1. S1 bar is 30 j cap. S2 bar is towards east, that is 20 meters. So 20 I cap. What about S3? It is difficult to write S3. So S3, I am showing here for S3, this is the displacement S3. This is the angle 45 degrees. Its displacement is 30 root 2 2 meters. To represent the vector, we should not change its magnitude and direction. So I just consider this vector at origin and its angle is 45 degrees. So I can take a component of this vector in this direction. This component vector is 30 root 2 meters into sin 45. Whereas this component, y direction component, is 30 root 2 cos 45. Now write the displacement vector S3. This S3 can be written as some 30 root 2 sin 45 minus I cap. And this is 30 root 2 cos 45 minus j cap. So this is 30 root 2, it takes a lot of space. So this S3 is 30 root 2 sin 45 minus I cap plus 30 root 2 cos 45 into 1 minute, 30 root 2 cos 45 into minus j cap. So this S3 bar is 30 sin 45 is 1 by root 2. This root 2 gets cancelled. This is 30 into minus I cap plus cos 45 is also 1 by root 2. This root 2 gets cancelled. So this is 30 minus j cap. Total displacement S bar is, we know it is S1 bar plus S2 bar plus S3 bar. S bar is S1 bar plus S2 bar plus S3 bar. Our S1 bar is 30 j cap, S2 is 20 I cap, S3 is minus 30, S3 is minus 30 I cap, minus 30 j cap. So on solving this, we can get this minus 30 j cap gets cancelled. So it is minus 10 I cap. So what is the resultant displacement from this coordinate system? If this is origin, the man moves towards the west for a distance of 10 meters. So this is the displacement vector of the man. So finally we can conclude that man moves 10 meters westwards. So once again I am repeating, this displacement S bar is S1 bar plus S2 bar plus S3 bar. S1 bar is 30 j cap, S2 bar is 20 I cap, S3 bar is minus 30 I cap, minus 30 j cap. So this minus 30 j cap gets cancelled. So on subtracting these two, we can get S bar is minus 10 I cap. What is minus 10 I cap? This is positive I and this is negative I. Negative I in the sense west direction. There is no negative magnitude for a displacement. Negative sign in the sense opposite direction. So this is minus 10 I cap. So we can say that man moves 10 meters westwards. Okay students, this is our next problem. In this problem, a person follows a track that turns to left by 60 degrees after every 100 meters. For every 100 meters, this track turns 60 degrees to his left. Find the distance and displacement of the person at the end of second turn, third turn and fourth turn. So we have to find distance and displacement in the following cases. This is one important problem. Okay. For this, I am taking the diagram. To solve any problem, first of all, we have to visualize the situation. Once we visualize the situation, it is easy to solve the problem. So for this, I am drawing the track. This track is in the form of, it is like this, man starts from here. Suppose this is 100 meters. From here he takes a turn towards left, to his left by 60 degrees, and then continued for another 100 meters, and then takes a turn to his left, and then continued for another 100 meters, and then continued for another 100 meters, and then continued for another 100 meters. This is the track. This is from point A, man moves 100 meters, reaches some point B, takes a left turn, and then reaches another point C, and then reaches another point D, first turn, second turn, third turn, or fourth turn, at the end of the fourth turn. This is E, and he finally reaches a point F. We have to calculate displacement. So first question is at the end of the second turn. So man starts from A and reaches B. I have to calculate distance and displacement. For first question, distance is 100 meters plus 100 meters, total 200 meters. So distance is 200 meters. What is displacement? What is displacement? Displacement is the shortest line, length of the shortest line. This is the shortest line. So if this is 60, this will be 120 degrees. So if I draw a perpendicular from here, it will be 90 degrees. For suppose this is some x, it is a right angle triangle. It is a right angle triangle. If this will be the x and this is also x, why? Because it is also right angle triangle. So displacement is simply 2x. Displacement is simply 2x. So by taking sine, it is 60 degrees. This is some m. If you consider triangle MBC or CMB triangle, sin 60 is nothing but x by hypotenuse, that is x by 100. So our x is 100 sin 60. We know that sin 60 is root 3 by 2, 100 root 3 by 2. So, I can write here, this displacement is 100 root 3 by 2 this is 100 2 into 100 root 3 by 2 meters into direction. It is a displacement, we have to mention the direction, that is AC cap, on cancelling the 2, we will get a displacement of 100 root 3 meters into AC cap. This is, he walks for 100 meters and then takes a turn through 60 degrees and then walks for another 100 meters, takes second turn and then walks for another 100 meters, takes third turn. Like this, he continued this hexagon. Which hexagon is this? It is a regular hexagon. We know that every side is 100 meters. If side lengths are same, that path is that shape is a regular hexagon. We already known from geometry, if it is a regular hexagon, if one side length is L and L, it's a diagonal. One diagonal is root 3L, another diagonal is 2L, and another diagonal is root 3L, and this is L. So, with this concept, you can solve this problem very easily. Distance travelled by the person is, this is first turn, here the first turn starts and here the first turn ends, and this is the diagonal. So, distance is 100 plus 100, 200 meters, and displacement is, length of this diagonal, this is root 3L, that is root 3 into 100. So, it can be written as root 3 is 1.732 into 100, that is 173.2 meters into AC cap. Here displacement is a vector quantity, so we have to mention the direction, that is AC cap. Next question is, second question, at the end of the second turn, for third turn, at the end of the third turn, distance is 100 plus 100 plus 100, that is 100 plus 100 plus 100, that is 300 meters. And displacement is 1st turn, 2nd turn, 3rd turn. So, this is the displacement. So, this displacement is, this is 2L, 2 into 100. So, from this we can calculate the diagonals. This is root 3 into 100 meters. This is 2 into 100 meters. This is root 3 into 100 meters. So, this is displacement. Our third question is, distance is at the end of the fourth turn, this is 100 plus 100 plus 100 plus 100. That is 400 meters. Displacement is, this is root 3 into 100. This is the displacement vector. So, root 3 into 100 into AE cap. This is the problem. It is very important for mains exam. Okay, practice this. Students, here is one important problem, that is an object moves on a circular path from A to B, find the distance and displacement. So, they are given, object moves on circular path from A to B in a circular path, as shown in figure, as shown. So some particle moves from here to here. We have to find distance and displacement of that particular particle. So if it is, what is the distance? Distance traveled by the particle is, distance traveled by the particle is length of this sector. We know that for a circle, if it is angle theta, its radius is r, length of the arc L is equal to r theta, length of the arc is equal to radius into angle. So distance traveled by the body, that is equal to, if this is some r, r into theta. If you consider this radius for some 10 meters and this theta in radians, this can be written as 10 into some angle. Angle may be 60 degrees, pi by 6 radians, pi by 3 radians, etc. But it is important, theta must be in radians, it should not be in degrees. Next, what is displacement? Displacement is length of the shortest line. This is the displacement. So displacement is, to calculate the displacement, I am dropping a normal. If this is 90 and this is r, from this it is some x. By considering sine, this is theta by 2. Sine theta by 2 is nothing but x by r. So x is r sine theta by 2. X is r sine theta by 2. So if particle starts from A and reaches B, then displacement is x plus x. So displacement is x plus x. This is 2x, or simply 2r sine theta by 2. This is displacement. Similarly, particle may move like this also. In such case, distance is 2 pi minus theta and displacement remains same. Displacement remains same. Students, here is one important problem, that is, a particle starts from A to A and reaches B and then to C. Particle starts from A and travels along A to B, reaches B and then B to C. So now we have to find displacement of the particle only. What is the displacement? This is the displacement, this is the shortest line, this is the displacement, this gives the displacement. What is displacement? Displacement is given by shortest line. So what is the length of the shortest line? It is difficult to calculate a displacement. Why? Because they are not given AB or BC. How to calculate this displacement? To calculate the displacement, we have to know one rule, that is, in case of rectangle, length of the diagonals are equal. So if it may be one side, it may be other side, its diagonal is this. Length of this diagonal is equal to length of this diagonal. So displacement is AC bar. This is nothing but R into AC cap. Actually this R is 10 meters. So 10 meters into AC cap is the displacement. It is one important problem. Students, I am explaining one more important problem. A particle's position, if position of a particle varies as y equal to t cube, it means this particle moves only on y axis. If this is y axis, particle moves on y axis. It obeys the equation y equal to t cube. So they are asking, find the displacement of particle from t equal to 1 second to 2 seconds. To find the displacement, what is displacement? Displacement is nothing but change in position. Here particle moving along y axis, so its position is change in position, that is y, delta y. That is y at t is equal to 2 seconds minus y, t is equal to 1 second. So this is change in position, or you can write it as y final minus y initial. So this is t equal to 2 means 2 cube minus 1 cube, or you can write it as y equal to y at t equal to t is 2 cube, y at t equal to 1 is 1 cube. So this is 8. If this is in meters, our displacement will be in meters. What is the direction in displacement? We have to mention the direction. It is moving along y direction. So it is j cap. Okay. Students, I have one more important problem here. A spider moves inside a cube of side length L as shown in figure. Find the distance and displacement of this spider. Here, spider starts at point A, it reaches some point P and then to Q, Q to some M, M to N, N to B. So, spider travels like this inside the cube. Let L be the length of this spider. The distance traveled by the spider is, the distance traveled by the spider is some S. Here it travels distance L, and here it travels distance L, and here it travels distance L. L plus L plus L, this is 3L. Here to here it travels a distance L, that is 4L, and here to here it travels another distance L, that is 5L. So distance traveled by the spider is L plus L plus L plus, or you can write it like this, A to P plus P to Q plus Q to M plus M to N plus N to B. This is L plus L plus L plus L plus L. So this is 5L. Like this, you can calculate distance in any case. Okay. What is displacement? Displacement. Displacement is the shortest line, length of the shortest line. So from A to B, it is a body diagonal of the cube. So it is the displacement of the cube. Displacement, body diagonal of the cube, that is, we know that it is root 3 L. So here displacement is root 3 into L into A B cap. This A B cap gives the direction of the displacement. Okay. Students, I have one more important problem here, that is, an ant moves on a solid cube from A to B, which is body diagonal. Find the minimum distance of the distance traveled by this ant. So here ant travels from here to here, they do not ask the displacement. We already calculated displacement is root 3 L, or root 3 times of length of the side. Here also consider L is the length of the side cube, side length of the cube. How to calculate the minimum distance traveled by the cube? To calculate the minimum distance, it may travel like this, here to here, or it may travel like this. So it is very difficult to calculate the displacement, particularly minimum displacement. To understand the situation, I am considering this upper face as some M, N, O, P. For the sake of convenience, I am opening the two faces here. This is upper face, our ant starts at A. This is A, M, N, O face. This is O, this is N. And this side face is this. This is O, N, P, B. This is the I am opening the face upside. So then it will be like this. This is A, M, N, O, P, Q. So if ant travels from this point to this point, it may travel like this, or it may travel like this, but I think it is the shortest distance traveled by the ant. So it is the shortest, so I have to calculate this length, the length of the AB, or this is some point P, some x. So shortest distance traveled by ant is AXB. How to calculate this AXB? This is some L. It is L. So it is also L. So here I have a right angle triangle whose one side length is L and another side length is 2L. Another side length is 2L. This is A and this is B. This is M. So I have to calculate the diagonal length of this triangle AMP. So its diagonal length is under root 2L whole square plus L square. And this is nothing but root 5L. So AXB length is nothing but root 5L. This is the shortest displacement of the ant. Sorry, shortest distance traveled by the ant. Okay. It is very, very important problem for mains. Okay. Try to solve the problem once again. Students, I have one more important problem here. This is a particle traveling along x-axis according to the equation x is equal to 2t square plus 1. Find the displacement for the time interval of delta t. We have to calculate displacement for delta t time interval. So to solve this problem, first consider time as some t, then our x coordinate, or it gives an initial x coordinate. This is 2t square plus 1. Then if you consider next time interval as t plus delta t, in such case x final is 2 into t plus delta t whole square plus 1. That is, this is on expanding, this is 2 into t square plus 2t delta t plus delta t square plus 1. So this displacement s is final exposition minus initial exposition. This is nothing but 2t square plus 2 into 2, 4t delta t plus 2 delta t square plus 1 minus x initial, that is 2t square plus 1. This 2t square gets cancelled, 1 also gets cancelled. So our displacement is 4t delta t plus 2 delta t square. Okay, like this we can calculate the displacement. Student, all practice all the problems what we have discussed today once again and practice well to get the good grip on distance and displacement concept. Thank you.